My name is Agatha Lenartowicz. We are at UCLA at the Semel Institute, and I'm a professional cognitive neuroscientist. So my task, my job, is to try to understand how the brain systems work that produce cognition, so things like attention, memory, and similar. And for me in particular, I am interested in understanding the neural systems that allow us to attend and control distractions. So I am Polish-Canadian. I'm actually an immigrant, and I moved to Canada when I was about 8 or 9, and I was raised in just outside of Toronto. I have always been fascinated with people, just how we behave, how we interact, how we make our choices. And what I've been fascinated with is the appearance of having control over these actions. It becomes clear if we look at the human being closely that we don't have that much control, that there is this sort of system inside that dictates the choices that we make and how we behave. And so I was very interested from the very beginning in understanding how people work. So when you're sitting on a bus and you're reading and you hear people in the bus speaking, in an ideal situation you're reading and you can ignore the voices. But sometimes you can't. And so when you think about why can't you ignore distractions, well, maybe you're tired. So that's fatigue. Maybe you're really excited by dinner this evening. So that's a distraction, but it's an internal distraction because it's a thought that's distracting you. So there are many reasons why distractions can happen. And so understanding how those different distractions come about through brain mechanisms, I think will be really fundamental to better understanding causes of distractibility or conditions like ADHD. So to measure brain activity, we use one of two techniques, one of which is magnetic resonance imaging, where individuals are laying down and we take a picture of their brain. And then we look at those images closer and use computer algorithms to understand how information flows from region to region. We also use a technique called electroencephalography, or EEG, where we use a cap which sits on the scalp, and it contains sensors that measure electrical activity coming from the brain.
The way this particular net works is these are sponges, and the sponges are soaked in a solution.
And this technique allows us to track very, very quickly, millisecond by millisecond, how the brain is activating. So it gives us time information about brain activity. I always think about the parents that I see who come in with kids with ADHD, or the adults who come in with ADHD, and I would like to be able to give them a concrete answer. You know, so what is wrong? What can I do? So if you're the type of person who is curious about the world and likes to solve puzzles and come up with new solutions to complicated problems, science is probably a fantastic path for you. Thank you.